In this video, I'm going to share my opinions on whether or not it's okay for someone with MS not to take a disease-modifying therapy. If you'd like to hear my take on the question, don't turn away, because that starts right now. Howdy! Thanks for learning about MS with me, Aaron Boster. I started this YouTube channel to help my own MS clinic patients learn between visits. And it's my hope that through these videos, I can help you learn too. Today, I want to discuss a recent Twitter post that I was sent. Someone tweeted at me and said, "Dr. Boster, can you remove your last comment where you said people with MS have to take a therapy? It's completely reasonable to not take a therapy with MS." That is not true. That is false, and I can't delete that comment. On the contrary, I'm going to do an entire video sharing with you why I feel passionately that you need to take a disease-modifying therapy. So let's jump in. The most pathologic damage, the period of time when there's the most structural brain damage to the brain and spinal cord, is during the first 5 years of the disease. Now, there's a trick here, because that's also the time that the human being feels the very best. They have the most functional reserve, they have the most neuroplasticity, they're the youngest they're ever gonna be, and they may have an attack and recover and have a false sense of I'm okay, and they're not okay. Because when you look pathologically, they're accruing neurological damage, brain damage, they're accruing inflammatory damage in the holiest of holies, the supercomputer that runs the body, and the spinal cord that takes all that information from the brain down and back up. It's like a highway. Now, you may rewire your brain and recover from the attack, but you still have brain damage. And the damage that you accrue during those first 5-10 years literally sets the trajectory of the disease over the next 20-30 years. Accruing brain damage early on is a setup for progression of disease downstream, and I want to explain that to you. I'll use an analogy of blowing holes in a wall with a shotgun. Now, I'm not a violent guy, I don't own a shotgun, but just humor me. So, boom, right? Punch a bunch of holes in the wall. And we don't patch the wall, we just leave the holes there. And then a couple years later, there's an earthquake. Well, which wall falls first? It's the one with the structural damage. When you have neurological damage, brain damage to your brain and spinal cord, and your brain at a young age is plastic and it's got a lot of functional reserve and you can rewire. 15 years down the line, that can wear out. And as your brain naturally ages, or in the setting of MS, if there's accelerated brain aging, those areas of structural damage eventually wear out. And that's the underpinnings of progression. My point here is, if we could instead prevent the early brain damage, we would set the person up to preserve their reserve, to preserve their neurological reserve, and to maintain healthy brain so that they can age more naturally. Now, many people at the beginning of the disease, they don't fully appreciate that, and many doctors don't understand that, and they think it's okay to watch and wait, or to start someone on a low efficacy medicine and see how it goes. And that drives me bonkers. If we apply a highly effective medicine as early as possible in as young of a person as possible, they have the best chance of changing the trajectory of the disease and having a slow disease trajectory. And that's what I want for you. We have to think about disease modifying therapies as birth control pills. Think about it this way. You have 3 children. If you take a birth control pill, you still have 3 children despite taking the birth control. They don't disappear. You take the birth control pill not to get rid of something that's already happened. Those children have already been born, but to prevent an unplanned event, in this case, an unplanned pregnancy. This analogy applies in MS because if you have symptoms of multiple sclerosis from damage that you've already suffered, so let's say that you have a burning leg. When you start disease-modifying therapy, the burning leg doesn't get any better. It's still there. We can't give you back the brain damage you've suffered. We're taking the disease-modifying therapy to prevent the other leg from getting a sensation of burning, to prevent future damage from occurring. But the drugs do more than that, guys. It's not just about decreasing attacks and decreasing new spots on the MRI. Particularly the newer medications have been shown to be able to reduce the rate of brain shrinkage, to literally slow down brain volume loss. they've been able to demonstrate, even in progressive disease states, that we can maintain hand function and maintain cognitive function in slow disability progression. There are four things that we know about in 2019 to slow down your disease, and I want you to do all four. I want you not to smoke cigarettes because that can speed up your disease by almost 50%. I want you to exercise as part of your lifestyle. I want you to supplement low levels of vitamin D, and I want you to take the most effective disease-modifying therapy that you're comfortable with as early as possible and for as long as possible. And we need to make sure that that therapy's working. We need to make sure that you're not failing the litmus test of life. We need to make sure that you're not having attacks. We need to make sure that there are no new spots on annual MRIs that we get. We need to make sure that your neurological testing isn't demonstrating disability progression. These are all critically important things if we're going to make you the most awesome version of you despite having MS. Now, many patients express therapeutic inertia and they throw up reasons why they can't do it. Number one, they say, oh, it's too expensive. I can't afford it. That's not true. In the United States, if you don't have insurance, it's actually very easy to apply for assistance programs. Most manufacturers will give you the drug for free. Most hospital systems have assistance programs built in, and there are government and there are other organizations outside of the government that provide assistance. We can find a drug that you can afford. There are even off-label drugs that are generic, that are very, very inexpensive that we can use. And one of my favorite things to consider is participation in a clinical trial that does not have a placebo arm. I'm talking about a modern MS trial where you're either on awesome MS drug A or potentially awesome or new MS drug B. And you may not know which drug you're on, but you're on a drug. And by the way, the drugs are paid for, and the visits are paid for, and the MRIs are paid for, and the labs are paid for. And so my point here is there are multiple ways of getting these drugs covered. I have never failed in coming up with a mechanism to get them on a drug. It might not be the first drug we pick, but we can get them on something. Now, the second thing that I very commonly hear is, oh, the side effects are intolerable, I can't handle it. And I think we have to think critically about that. Yes, there are side effects to medicines. Yes, there are risks to medicines. And yes, you're allowed to have reservations and concerns. But there are 17 different formulations of medicines, guys. And we can find the one that you're comfortable with. I want you on the most effective drug that you're comfortable with. And if you're concerned about an infection risk, don't take that drug. And if you have trouble injecting yourself with a needle, don't take a shot. And if you have trouble remembering to take a pill twice a day, pick a drug that isn't a twice a day pill. And if you're scared of infusions, don't do that. If you travel a lot, then we can pick a drug that matches that lifestyle. And if you have comorbid conditions, we can match a drug that fits you with the comorbid problems that you have. We can make it work. My name's Aaron Boster, and I want to thank you for taking a few moments to learn about MS with me and to hear why I feel it is so critically important that we fight back hard and early and don't stop, because I want to make you the most awesome version of you possible despite having MS. And so thank you for listening to me, and I would love to hear your thoughts and your comments. Please take a moment and leave them down in the section below. I would love to read them, and I'll look forward to responding to them. And if you enjoyed this video and would like to hear future content from me, that's awesome! Please take a moment and subscribe to the channel by hitting that red button. And if you hit the notifications bell, it'll remind you when I put out new content. I'm trying to put out a video once or twice a week. And until my next video, this is Aaron Boster saying thank you and take care.